Hey, welcome back to another Stranger Objects tutorial. My name is David Drayton, and today I will show you how you can import and use Open VDB files in Blender. Today's video is not sponsored, but supported by the Pixel Lab. Joran Kandel, a good mate of mine, supported me by handing out some of his beautiful VDBs that they're selling on their own shop. And for this tutorial, I am using the Portal Shop. So please check them out. They have some really good products. And without further ado, let's jump right in there. So welcome back to Blender. This is the scene file we'll be working on. I'll leave a link in the description where you can download this scene file for free. It also has some of my SO texture pack textures included, so it's free. And if you like more, you can just go and head over to Gumroad and buy for $4.99 my SO texture pack for Blender and any other packages. So how do you get VDBs into Blender 3D? It's fairly easy. All you need to do is you have to add with Shift a volume object, and it's called Import Open VDB. Just click on this and Blender will ask you where to find those VDB files. I have mine in the download folders and it's called Portal 014 Low Res. I'm using a low res version of the high res version, which is also available from the same portal. But for preview purposes and tutorials, I think it makes more sense to use the lower version. So as you can see, it's a sequence, so the VDB is also animated. And if you need to get anything that's a sequence or image sequences into Blender, all you need to do is press A to select all and import volume. So as you can see, there's basically nothing to see. That's because it's a sequence of VDBs. But as soon as you start scrubbing through the timeline, you can see something is appearing in our viewport. To my taste, it's a little too big, so I will scale it down. I will grab and constrain the Z axis to move it up. And I will also rotate it by pressing R and holding down, pressing Z and holding down control and moving along the Z axis around 90 degrees. So we got our portal animated VDB up here. And as you can see, we don't see anything. So it's time to hit that render button to see if it's there. And yes, we can already see. One note on this, I'm in absolutely love with Cycles X. It's super fast, even on my computer, which is a MacBook 16-inch Intel non-GPU version, unfortunately, but it's super, super fast and it helps to make previewing stuff like this super easy. But yes, from here on, you don't have to scrub. I'm going to show you how you can just leave it on frame one. So we go back to frame one and use the offset. For example, if you want to render a still frame, you don't have to scrub all the way through, then render the still. You can also use the offset method to scrub through an open VDB sequence, which is pretty fine if you ask me. To shade that VDB, we're gonna pull up a new window to bring up the shader editor. Let's put them side by side, like so. And shader editor with the VDB selected, which you can see is yellow highlighted in the viewport. I will create a new material, and Blender is so smart to offer us already a principled volume, which I think it's absolutely fantastic. So I want to match my color to something more purplish on that side, and I also want to change the density of our file. So I just increase the density maybe to something like, let's say 10, to make it really thick smoke. And yeah, and basically that's it. There's like nothing more to add. It's just that simple. It's just that easy. And if you like that short styles of tutorials, please let me know in the comments. And if you not have done so yet, please subscribe and leave a like, and tell your friends, family, and all you think that should know about my channel. And I see you in the next one. Take care. Bye-bye.